so the first one that we're going to speak to is a situation that may occur where you have no liquid being delivered in the system. So I wanted to give a little background and what this means in terms of conditions. And this means the pump is operating. You know that the motor is running, the pump is rotating. You know that the suction and discharge valves are open in the system, but you have no flow through the system at all. And so this would be a condition that would be called no liquid being delivered in the system. And I've got a few different causes of what may happen or what may be causing this to occur within the system, and then followed by some of the different remedies that you may take to be able to resolve the issue. So one of these would be that the pump is not primed. And so we're talking specifically about centrifugal pumps, and centrifugal pumps are not able to prime unless they happen to be a self-priming technology. So your typical centrifugal pump is not going to be able to self-prime. And that means if there's no fluid inside the pump, we need to look at priming it. So if you have a lifted a suction lift at your pump, then you may need to look at re-priming the pump, and you may look to make sure that your suction line is full of liquid, and you're going to need to do some troubleshooting here. If you've got an elevated a flooded suction where your fluid source is above the pump, this is probably not going to be your issue. But if your fluid level is below your pump, you may need to look at taking steps to reprime the pump and make sure that suction line is fully filled with fluid. And additionally, you might have some level of obstruction on your suction line. And so this would cause a restriction of flow from the pump into the system or into the pump. And if you have an obstruction, you're going to need to look at identifying where it is and removing it. A very common obstruction could be a clogged suction strainer. And these are installed on a lot of different systems. And if that has become clogged and it's blocking fluid, you may need to clean it to allow the fluid to flow through. Another area within a centrifugal pump that would be would be a possibility is if you've actually clogged your impellers, one of your impeller vanes or multiple impeller vanes. And this could happen if you had some sort of a fluid solidify in a pump when it was not operating, and you go to start it up, and now the impeller had that fluid solidify inside the vanes. You could have some large solids passing through that get stuck inside the impeller, and removing these types of obstructions will allow the pump to start operating correctly. Another possible cause here is that the pump is operating, but it's rotating in the wrong direction. And so the impeller is specifically designed to displace fluid when it's running in its designed rotation. And if the motor is wired to rotate in the wrong or the opposite direction, you may not see fluid flow coming out of your pump. And so you can take a look at this and make sure that the rotation direction is correct. Now, there's also a note here. Running a pump in the wrong direction can be very catastrophic, depending on the way the impeller is mounted to a shaft. If you have a keyed impeller with a lock screw or a lock nut, then it's not likely to have this issue. But if the impeller is threaded onto the shaft, when you run a pump in the reverse direction, that impeller can actually begin to de-thread from the shaft, and that ultimately can cause essentially a jacking motion where you lock the impeller up on the casing and then force the shaft back through the power frame. It's going to be a very catastrophic failure for a pump. So beyond just not getting fluid flow, it could cause very severe damage to a pump if it's operated in the wrong direction. So you might also have a suction condition issue if your pump has a foot valve or potentially the suction pipe has not been submerged properly into the fluid. And so if you have a suction lift and your suction pipe is not properly submerged into the fluid, you may be seeing vortexing or some other type of failure just because of the conditions of the suction pipe as it's entering into the fluid. So you need to look for this. And if it's an open reservoir, you may be able to see vortexing occurring on the surface of the fluid. And if that's the case, you can actually submerge the suction pipe further in the fluid, and that can typically resolve an issue when it comes to vortexing. And then finally, even if your pump is primed and you've got the right suction conditions and things like that, you may have too significant of a suction lift. And if that's occurring, you need to look at your design and see if you can do some adjustment. The pumps are going to have a limited ability to lift fluid into the pump.